Back control, Charlie 3-1, that's a message. Hello, and my name is Alex. I'm the Deputy Assistant Commissioner at Metropolitan Community, and today I bring you a video of myself roleplaying as a civilian within the community. There's only one scenario here, as that is all that we had time for, as we did have a debriefing to go, and therefore it was also cut short as well. This is an uncut video, so you are going to hear laughing, but to be honest with you, that's what it's all about. It's all about having fun. The officers in attendance, PC King, PC Pope, both of them done a fabulous and amazing job, absolutely amazing. And Mr. King got issued a gold commendation, Mr. Pope got issued Officer of the Shift Awards for demonstrating excellent policing. Just goes to show, as a traffic officer, you're not always going to be get sent to the fast roads jobs. You're going to be get sent to interesting jobs. And I have to say, I bet Mr. King, Mr. Pope, that was the most interesting job you've ever been sent to. So well done to the pair of you, and I do hope all of you watching this take something away from it to be able to yourself put in within your own role-playing experiences. Many thanks for your time. I do hope that you enjoy. Thank you.
What's Charlie 3-2 in channel?
Got the traffic today.
We got currently anyone on scene?
No, I'm about 3 minutes away.
All right, I'm currently on scene. Got no sight of the cyclist. What description have we got?
I see one male.
I see one.
That's it. Male's wearing a yellow t-shirt with a backpack. So let's just do their research quick.
All right then.
Anyone up there? Anyone?
Was it, did it specify that it was a cyclist, not a motorcyclist, or?
No, it says motorcyclist. Motorist.
Ah, well, there's a motorcycle back
no,
there.
No, hold on. No, motorist. I see one young male appears to be in distress while cycling southbound. Oh. So we're going the completely wrong way.
Alright.
He's gotta be up here, really. Ah,
here he is. That should be him. Will I pull in front, or you wanna pull in front?
Pull over, mate. Thank you.
Hello. Why are you stopping me?
Hi mate, nothing to worry about. Excuse that. You everything alright today?
Yeah.
Sure?
Yeah.
We've had a call from the member of the public who's sounds a bit worried. He seems to think you're a bit distressed
incident. I'm fine.
You sure?
Where have you been coming from today? Up there.
Where's up there?
I was coming from up in Essex, cycling over from Essex.
Cycling over from Essex?
Yeah, from the north.
I'll just update control.
Okay. So obviously, where are you off to now then?
I'm just cycling around.
Yeah. Yeah, because obviously, just the concern today with someone feels that you were a bit distressed.
No, I'm
any
fine.
Any reason for this?
No, I'm fine.
Yeah, any issues, anything you want to tell us about or talk to us about?
No, yeah. Can I go, please?
You can do for me. It'd be good if we could get your name and stuff and we can just do some quick checks on you.
But why would you need my name?
Right. I can see you're upset and you're a bit distressed, okay? So do you just want to put your bike on the side of the pavement
I
and come and have a sit in my car and have a chat?
I don't want to leave my bike because it's been stolen once and I don't want to get stolen again.
Don't worry. You don't need to worry about that. It's not going to get stolen while there's two officers here.
Look,
if you come over here, look, you can put it right here on the side of my car. Preferably not on the car though, because it's a brand new BM. Just lay it right there on the floor, and you'll be fine. Right, do you have a quick sit in the back of the car, and we'll have a quick chat, or in the front of the car, whichever you want.
I'll sit in the back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Right, you got no medical issues or anything?
No. I just want to go now.
You just got what, sorry?
I just want to go.
Just want to go. Is there any chance of me getting your name?
Why do I need to give you... Achoo! Sorry. Have you got a tissue?
Yeah, hold on. Let me just get one out of the bag. There you go, pal.
Thank you.
No problem.
Achoo! Oh, sorry. A load of snot just came out my nose. I'm so sorry.
It's alright, don't worry. That's what your tissues are for.
I'll just move my vehicle.
Right. Really, what I want to do is, because I can
three,
see you...
3-2, is it?
Yes, 3-2, yeah.
Yeah, if you can book off and book back... I've cleared you from system. If you can log off, book off, sign off, and then rebook off.
Yes.
Can I have another tissue, please? It is so cold in here.
Yeah, I'll take the packet, don't worry.
Thank you.
No problem. Right, you got any... Should we just find out your name and then your age? I won't run any checks on you, don't worry about that. I just want to know your name so I know who I'm talking to.
My name is Bobby.
Bobby. My name's Toby, okay?
Hello.
Right, hello. Obviously, so today you've biked all the way from Essex, yeah?
Yeah.
Is there any reason for this?
No.
Just felt like biking from Essex?
Yeah.
Yeah. Can I ask you your age, if that's alright?
Why?
I just want to know what your age is, because you look quite young for me.
I'm 8. I'm 18.
You're 18, are you sure?
Yeah, I am 18.
Can I have your date of birth to double check that?
It is so cold in here.
Cold? Yeah, I'll put the heating on for you.
My date of birth is April the 20th, 2000.
2000, okay.
I think I've got to go and eat, mate.
Oh, so sorry.
So, obviously you've been... I'm just struggling trying to work out why you've just biked all the way from Essex, because it's quite a far, long bike. It'll take a while.
I just wanted to go somewhere different.
Do you live with any family? Have any family?
No. I don't want to talk about that.
Right. What was your date of birth again? Sorry, it was...
20th of April,
2000. Okay. Right. You got any jobs or anything?
No.
What's your career aspiration?
I don't know.
You don't know?
And a boyfriend.
You don't know? Fancy a job? What's your kind of job things you like? What things do you like to do?
I like playing football.
You like playing football, so
yeah.
Do I.
I'm really hungry. Any other sports? Have you got anything to eat? I'm so sorry to ask.
Really hungry? I think I've got a couple of packet crisps. What flavour do you like? Salt and vinegar, ready salted, they're the only two I've got. Which flavour?
I'll have salt and vinegar, please. Actually, have you got a drink? Because if I eat, yeah, then I'm going to need a drink.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, you can have my meal deal. Is it ham sandwich?
I don't like ham.
You don't like ham? What about if you take the ham out and just put the crisps in it?
Yeah, okay, thank you so much.
And here's a bottle of water for yourself.
Thank you, Toby. Thank you. You're like the only person that's been really nice to me.
That's something. So I just need to get a little bit of detail about yourself. So do you live with your family then? Do you live with your mom, your dad, stepdad, stepmom?
I don't want to speak about that.
Right. Right. I can see you're in distress and something's wrong, but I need to talk to you. I need to be able to get some ideas. You've not ran away from home or anything, have you? Because I can see you.
Why would you say that? Why would you just say that? Why?
No, just listen
like
to you. Listen
me
to you. Come
wrong.
On. I've not. Listen, don't cry. I've not accused you of anything. I was just a general question.
You don't want
to talk about your family or anything, so I need to know. Because it's your. At the end of the day, it's your safety I'm looking after.
I don't like telling people where I live because people pick on me.
People pick on you. Right, why do people pick on you?
Because I live in a special home, a special place. That's what my friend says. What, you live in a care home?
Where do you live?
I don't want to say anymore about where I live.
Don't worry. I can always go and do some checks on you if you want. I can find out for you. You don't have to tell me.
Well, I don't want you to know, because people pick on me. You might take the mickey.
They ain't going to take the mickey. No one's going to know that this conversation's happened. It's just me and you here. No one else is going to find out anything. Do you live in a care home then, or where do you live?
I live like right near the beach.
You live near the beach?
In Essex, up at the top in Essex. It's a nice little village, and there's like a beach.
So you live up near Prospio Beach, is it? Near Palito area?
Yeah, up there in the nice little village. It's okay. Yeah. There's like a little school and it's.
What's your school? Do you enjoy that?
It's college. It's okay.
What are you studying?
I do like English and maths and life skills.
English, maths. I remember doing them. Do you do anything else?
No, I don't.
Are they kind of your favourite things in English and maths? Are they what you want to do?
I don't know what I want to do.
You don't know. Fair enough. Right. I tell you what I would do is... Obviously, because... Have you got an address for your place you've been?
Why are you asking me these questions?
Because the thing I'm worried about is... I know you're 18, but... I just need to make sure everything's all right. Do you have a number so I can talk to someone to say it's okay for you to be out here and stuff?
Why would you be asking these questions?
Because I'm just trying to get an idea of what you're doing and stuff.
You're all right, mate.
Uh,
Yeah, just have a sit in the car.
Who's this?
Oh, alright, mate.
This is one of my colleagues from the traffic.
I don't like it, mate. He smells funny.
I smell funny. Oh, I haven't heard that one before. So, I'm Officer Jay Pope, right, from the Central North London Borough.
Do you live in Canterbury?
No, I don't, mate. No, I live, actually out of county. Sorry, say that again.
Isn't there, like, a Pope in Canterbury?
I'm sure there is, yes, but I'm pretty sure I'm not him. But I'm from the Road Traffic Policing Command. I'm just checking up on you today, mate. Are you okay? What seems to be the problem?
Nothing's the problem.
Well, do you mind if I come and have a seat in the back of the car with you, and we can have a little bit of a chat?
Have you got any food on you? Because I'm really hungry.
Have I got any food? I think I've got some. I think I might have a sandwich in that in the back of the car. I think it's a cheese sandwich. I think it is. I'm not sure. I mean, if that's all right for you.
Yeah.
All right then. Yeah, 1 second.
Okay. Yeah. Please. Yeah. User joined your channel.
Right. Pope.
Yeah.
Can you get the bike and put it in your car for me, please?
Let me get in me this cheese sandwich out the back of my car. Cause
another sandwich? I've just given you one.
Sandwich anyway. Enjoy that. And right, Matt, what I'm going to do is I'm not taking your bike anywhere or anything. I'm just going to stick it in the back of my car, safe, right? And then this officer's going to tell you what we're going to do next, all right? So sit in there, enjoy your sandwich, and we'll be with you in a second.
Okay.
Care home. What they're called? Not care homes. Fuck. What they're called, Josh? They're not care homes. What they're called? I forgot what they're called now.
Is it, What is it regarding?
Like the child homes and stuff they stay in.
Oh, is it a foster home?
That's it.
Foster home. There you go. Do we just pull round because we're on quite a steep hill here?
Do I find results? Actually, there's a car park around the corner. Well, I'm just going to pull around the corner. Right, we're just going to park in the car park because it's a bit safer.
What?
Just siren it, mate. Get through.
Where are you taking me?
We're just gonna park in this car park here. Look to our right. Nothing to worry about.
Okay.
Just so we're nice and safe now, aren't we?
Okay.
You backing in?
Yeah, I was backing. I know we'd go forward. Right. Could you answer chat, please?
You enjoy your cheese sandwich, mate?
The cheese is a bit funny, though.
No, it shouldn't be. My wife made it for me this morning. I had one.
That's why, then.
I had one this morning, and I didn't really fancy the second one, so, yeah. Suppose it worked out quite good.
Whereabouts
you from then, mate?
Why are you asking this?
Just polite conversation. I'm sure you ask when you meet someone where they're from and what's their name and that. It's just polite conversation. I'm sure that you know who I am and where I'm from.
Where are you from?
Where I'm from? I live actually quite, I wouldn't say Polito area, it's just down from there, it's quite a rural house. It's just off the train line.
You ring this number.
And we've got a really nice place, it's all...
What was his full name again? It was...
What is your name, mate, for a second, if you don't mind giving me that?
I only said my name is Bobby.
You only said your name is Bobby? Yeah. Well, Bobby, name? What's your last name, mate?
Why do you want to know who?
I don't know.
Well, you know who I am. My name's Josh Pope with the Metropolitan Police.
Right.
So.
Okay, ring his number. Ring, 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 ring.
Good evening. Hello.
Hello. Is that the care home in Polito Bay?
Yes. Oh, hello. My name is Joan. How can I help you?
Hi. My name's PC King. I'm from Roads and Traffic Policing Department.
Sorry, speak up, love.
I said my name's PC King, I'm from the Roads and Traffic Policing Department.
You're PC Ming?
King. K-I-N-G.
Oh, hello PC King, and where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Roads and Traffic Police.
Are you a traffic warden?
I'm a traffic officer.
Oh, how can I help you, PC King?
Hi. Right, have you got any people, any person
yeah,
missing
from your
care home?
Yeah, there's lots of people.
Home?
Oh, missing, oh, there was
any
actually,
chance goes by the name Bobby?
There was actually one chap, I think. Let me just go and have a look in the paperwork. Where's that? Oh, I'm so sorry. Everything's everywhere in this place. Jean? Have you got the missing file paperwork? Yes. It's Bobby, isn't it? Yes. Hello, officer. Hello, PC
hello.
Ming.
King, hello.
Hi, PC Ming. I'm so sorry.
Fucking dimbat. Wrecked it. Yeah, PC King, hello.
Yes, there is a young chap that's missing.
Yeah, what's his name?
His name is Bobby Pinch, I think. Bobby Finch.
Bobby Pinch.
No, Bobby Finch. Sorry. Jean's got a bit of a mouth issue. She's currently
Bobby
eating.
Bobby Finch. Is that spelled F-I-N-C-H?
Yes. He's a young lad. He's such a wonderful lad. And sometimes I sit down with him and I used to talk to him about all the stories about, you know, during the war and all that kind of stuff. He used to be very interested with my stories.
Could you tell me his name? How old are you, sorry?
He's 18.
Could you give me a brief description of him?
Well, he's male for starters, so he'd look like him.
Looks like what, sorry?
He's male. He's got like scruffy hair. And do you know what? I think am I speaking about the right person? Yeah, he's got, I think he ran away, he had like a backpack on him, and I'm not sure, but he might have had a yellow t-shirt or something, PC Ming, so, user left your have you found him? Because he's such a lovely boy.
Yeah, so at the minute, we got called to a male who was, looked a bit distressed by another person, and he's, We've rolled up on scene and
you were called to a person that looked to be in a dress?
In distress, sorry.
What? In distress? Oh, okay.
Another driver who was passing thought he was a bit distressed,
passing,
so that's why we were called.
What was the driver passing exactly? Was he actually in the car or was he elsewhere, if you know what I mean?
No, Bobby was on a bike. He says he came all the way from Essex.
Yeah, that's where we are,
And now he's all the way down in Los Santos.
Oh, yeah, sorry, you called me, my bad.
Yes. Yeah, okay. So what we're going to do is we've got him in the back of our cop car at the minute. We've got his bike and stuff. What we'll do is...
Yeah, they want your Chinese, Gene. Gene, you need to call the Chinese place. They're going to go mad if you call... They're going to go mad if you call the pizza people.
Sorry, what?
Sorry, PC Ming. Sorry, I'm speaking to Jean over there. She's ordering a Chinese for herself, the breeding bitch.
Okay. Right, what we're going to do is, we'll be up in about half an hour. We're going to bring up Bobby to you, okay?
Half an hour? Where were you calling from, PC Ming?
I'm calling from Los Santos. Down in the bottom bit of London.
In London? Oh, what are you going to do? Get a helicopter or something? Because the traffic these days is a nightmare.
No, don't worry about that. I know the motorways very well. No, we'll be driving.
Just because you
cars,
know the motorways, PC Ming, doesn't mean to say you can get here fast because all the traffic's going to move out of your way. Oh, I suppose you have some those lights, don't you? What are they, like green lights? Blue lights, that's it, blue lights.
Blue lights,
My eyesight's not very good these days and my memory ain't exactly amazing either.
Yeah. Right, yeah, no, don't worry about that. We'll be up in about half an hour, okay? It's my name's PC King, my caller number's Tango 160. If you need to get me...
Tango Orange?
Tango 160.
Who won Tango?
No. If you want to write this down on a piece of paper for me.
Yeah.
Okay, right.
Gene, cover your pen, please.
Tell me when you're ready.
You having much luck, mate?
Gene!
Yes, lovely phone call.
Gene, can you go and get Jeffrey and give me his pen, please?
Just wait for Gene to give the pen.
What about...
Yeah, she sounds like a nice woman.
Arnold, they are. Arnold, I know you're doing the crossword, but can I borrow the pen, please? Arnold, don't bite stop it, Arnold, stop it. Otherwise you're getting no Chinese. I mean pizza, sorry. Gene, order the takeaway. He's nibbling the pen. He's that hungry. Oh, sorry, I forgot all about you, PC Ming. I'm so sorry. What was it that I was going to get? Oh, a pen! Oh, I'm sorry, I'll be back.
Alright, are you ready, yeah? Are you ready to write this down?
Give me the pen, Gene. Thank you, Gene. Okay, paper. I need paper now.
Having a bit of a trouble getting a pen.
And paper now.
Oh, there we go! I found some paper. Oh, this is the Chinese menu, Gene!
That'll do. Just write it on the back of that. That'll do.
Okay, PC Ming. Let's go, PC Ming. Do I
right,
get a number, PC Ming?
If you
PC
write
Ming?
This down, put T, the letter T.
Letter L-E-T-T-E-R-T.
Yes. And put 160 next to the letter T.
P-U-T-O-N-E-S-I-X-Z-E-R-O.
She's spelling out everything, can I say?
E-X-T.
Do you want to pass the phone to me?
Sorry, are you spelling out everything, can I say?
Well, you said you need to write...
Listen. I'm going to give you a number, okay? 160. Just write that. Don't write the word right. Just write 160.
O-N-E-S-I-X-Z-E-R-O. Yeah, anything else?
Right.
Do you want to pass the phone to me?
And my station, you can get me at. Yeah, you don't need to write that. Just write the station name.
Are you calling from an FM radio station, 160?
No, I'm... Right, I tell you what, I'll see you in half an hour, okay? Okay?
Okay, sweetheart, would you like some Chinese? I mean, pizza.
I'm sure Bobby will, though. He's a bit hungry.
Okay, then.
I'll have some Chinese.
Okay, thank you, bye.
Bye-bye, PC Ming.
Bye. Whoa, that was an eventful phone call. Right, Bobby, how you doing?
Yeah, I'm okay. I'm alright.
Yeah, you're not hungry at all anymore.
Why are you offering a meal? Because I'm starving, mate.
Do you want to go past Matt Dunnell?
Shoot! Oh, I'm sorry. I just put a load of snot on your back seat. Oh man, I'm so sorry.
It's alright. Just wipe it off.
It's not my car normally, anyway.
Do you want to go past Matt Dunnell's?
Oh, McDonald's. I'd love McDonald's.
Please. That's okay,
yeah. Right,
sorry, officer, I'm sorry, but I'm running out of tissues, so I've got to wipe it on your shoulder. There you go.
On my shoulder, thank you. I tell you what, here's another packet out my bag.
Officer, you shouldn't be, like leaning over whilst driving, you know.
My bag's right next to me.
Okay. I'm so hungry. We're going to go to McDonald's, are we?
Yeah, we're going to go and get a McDonald's. Right. What do you like?
Burger King, McDonald's. I like Chinese. Chinese is
like Chinese. Okay. What do you prefer? McDonald's is just up here. It'd be easier.
I do like a Chinese buffet.
Chinese buffet. I haven't really got time for that personally, but tell you what, let's just jump past McDonald's because it's nice and easy to get to.
Okay. What do you mean? I'm not. Where's my bike? Where's my bike?
Your bike.
Where's my bike?
You see the cop car behind it.
Oh, okay. It's in the back of that cop car. I'm not jumping to McDonald's. You said jump to McDonald's. I can't jump.
You don't need to jump. Don't worry.
Okay.
I don't know why you said that, but yeah. Right, and then as soon as we've got you some food, I'll explain what we're going to do, okay?
Yeah. I'm sorry, I'm just pissing myself laughing here. I'm so sorry.
What do you think? What is this car doing?
Oh, there's a car there. There's a car there. Someone's found the horn.
Yeah. Right, what would you like?
Move along. What are you doing here?
Can I have a cheeseburger, a decent sized burger?
Yeah.
Large chips.
Yeah.
I'll have a Pepsi. Or do they do Coke?
I think it's Coke.
Okay, I'd have Coke. A large Coke. I would also like 6 chicken nuggets. 12 onion rings.
12 onion rings. Yeah, you're not gonna be able to eat all of it, surely.
Mate, I'm starving. I'm starving.
Hey.
Are you sure you're okay getting this? I've got no money, so.
It's not a problem.
So I wanted the burger. I wanted large chips. I want a large Coke. 6 chicken nuggets. 12 onion rings. Do you do any desserts?
I think they do some ice cream, but it's quite hot today, so that may be a struggle. I tell you what, why don't we eat this, and then we'll come back, and we'll get you an ice cream.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Right, yeah. Let's pay for that.
Do I get my can of Coke?
I think you get a big tub of it.
No, I want a can. I can't do them type. I need a can.
They don't do can. Oh, tell you what, I'll have your Diet Coke they're giving you. Look what I've got.
I did not have a Diet Coke, I had for a Coke.
Look how it is, look, what's this? Diet Coke in my bag.
But I asked for a Coke, I need Coke. I'm not on a diet, you see.
Oh. Josh, do you have a Coke in your bag?
Sorry mate, say that again.
Do you have a Coke in your bag?
I'm not sure, my missus normally puts me orange squash, but I'll have a look for you, one sec. Oh, look at that, yeah. Oh, I mean, it's Diet Coke, though.
Oh, for God's sake. Right, don't leave it. We'll get you one from the shop.
Just give me the, I'm thirsty, just give me the can.
Alright, one sec then.
There you go.
Oh, you got one.
Wait, he's actually got one. What the fuck? I wish I had one then. Right, cool then. What is this car doing? Hello? I ain't gonna be able to fit past that.
Hello, love. Yeah,
I can't get past that.
Signature with bacon, please. Large meal. Yep.
Yeah, for what?
Can I also have, what are those? Those cheese bites that you get? Yeah, them as well. And I'll have a banana milkshake with that as well. Brilliant. Thank you, love.
That was lovely.
Yes, please go to the next window. Thanks.
Really? I'm so sorry. This is what happens when they give me Coke at the home.
This is tight. Oh, this is going to be fun without scratching the car. Pro driver there. He's just scratched all his car, mate.
I haven't.
I'm telling the sergeant. Yeah, you did.
It didn't come up on mine.
Right. Tell you what, I don't even know where this address is up here. That's the one thing I didn't ask, because you just kept going. I couldn't stop laughing until... So, I don't even know the address, so we'll just go.
I think I did hear it. It was up in Palito.
Ring, ring!
Yeah, no, I knew it.
Ring, ring!
Hello?
Hello, is that PC Ming?
PC King, yes.
Hello, PC Ming, my name is Joan, I'm calling from the care home.
Hello?
Hello, I was wondering if you could tell me how long you were going to be, because we need to pop out to the shop.
Need to pop out to the shop? Well, surely shouldn't someone be staying with the, with your people there?
No, Jean's absolutely fine.
So Jean's staying with them. She's a member of staff, yeah?
Yeah.
Okay, then, we're still half an hour away.
We're all
so.
Going. We're all taking a walk down to the shop.
What, all of you? Everyone in the
yeah,
house?
Yeah. It's a day trip. We're going to the shop.
Right, okay.
We're going to get an ice cream.
I'll tell you what.
We're going to get an ice cream
is...
with a flake in it, and then we're going to get 100,000 on it, and then we're going to go down to the beach. We're going to sit on the beach, and we're going to check out the sun, we're going to get a tan.
Right, I'll tell you what,
fall
then.
Asleep, and then we
you
might
lot
head
go,
back.
You lot go down to the beach and stuff, yeah? And then in about half an hour, 40 minutes...
But hold on. You said half an hour about 15 minutes ago.
Yeah, well, unfortunately, I didn't leave as quick as I thought I'd leave. We had to get you
PC
Bobby
Ming,
some food.
If I remember rightly, it was you that said you know your way around the roads.
I am, but I'm on the back road, so... No, I'm on my way. And we're on our way now, okay?
Where are you, PC Ming?
I'm up near the top of London, near Tottenham.
Oh, I see, PC Ting. Okay, I'm going to. Jean said, would you like a bed for the night? Because it's a long journey.
No, don't worry about that. I'll drive back.
Are you sure?
Yeah, that's not a problem.
Okay.
Radio's King. King, mate. If we could pull over. Down the road on the to the petrol station because my car's running a bit low.
You're on your own then. Yeah, okay, I need a might as well.
Okay,
stop, so.
Okay, PC Ming. So just hold up. Stop singing, Jean! We're all coming on a summer holiday.
Right,
don't worry, shut up, you miserable bitch!
We'll be there in a bit. One of you guys just needs to meet us
hello?
In about 25
hello?
Minutes.
PC
hello?
Ming? Oh,
yeah,
oh,
hello.
I fucking muted myself. How do I get the
oh
mute off?
God.
How do I... Hello?
Hello.
Oh, hello, PC Ming. How are you?
Very good.
PC Ming, are you driving?
Yes, but I have a Bluetooth in my ear.
Sorry?
I have a Bluetooth in my ear. We are driving now. We're about 25 away.
Okay. What I'll do is I'll hold on a minute. Jean, can you just shut up?
Right.
PC Ming?
Yeah, hello.
Can I ask, am I currently distracting you from your driving duties?
Not really, no. Well,
are you going to
King, I'm gonna go back on duty, mate.
Right.
Because we've got an incident.
I need your bike, though. I need the bike.
Oh, yeah. Do you want to pull
PC
down?
PC Ming, I have a friend who works at the hospital.
Oh, God. Right, I'm doing
near...
down here.
Oh, where's the hospital? The
pull over at the petrol station down there.
The hospital is at... The hospital is at Strawberry Avenue.
Yeah.
Just near the motorway. If you drop Bobby off there and ask for Jonathan, Jonathan will look after Bobby and we will come and get him. Is that okay? Because it
surely...
seems like your half an hour has turned into three flipping hours, mate.
Surely isn't he a bit busy?
Who, Jonathan?
Yeah.
No, I mean, he's basically what I do over there. I mean, what I do here over there, though.
Right, okay. But the thing is, I need...
PC
I need
Ming...
To...
PC Ming, I can hear some sort of static as if you're like in a petrol station.
Yeah, I am actually.
Can I just make you aware that you shouldn't have... I mean, seriously, I'm a 75-year-old lady having to tell a police officer when not to use a mobile phone in a petrol station.
Yeah, I'm not using my mobile phone. It's actually on my radio.
Which is listening. Don't argue with me, young man.
Can I just confirm what job it is, please?
This is a job with a...
distressed mile-long bike.
Cool.
Alright, received. Many thanks.
Yeah, King, here you go, mate. Here's the bike.
Thank you. Let's
one
put that
second.
In the back.
Right. Yeah, let me place it in the back. You're going to have to help me with this because it's a bit heavy.
Yeah,
Gene, he hasn't made up his mind yet, hold on.
I forgot his name. I forgot his name. Yeah, right, don't worry. Right, what's going to happen is, I need to come up to Essex, okay? Because I need to have a look
13501, this
stuff,
is via
I need to
Whisperer.
Sign some paperwork and stuff. I can't really do it down here. The only time I'd be able to do it down here is...
I've just got an old guy call, Matt. I've got a rocket ship. All the best.
Charlie, you're attached
to
this.
See ya. Right. Because the reason is, I need to make sure everything's okay up there and I need you to sign paperwork and stuff. But I can't really do that down here in London. The only way I'd be able to do that down here
What about, sorry to interrupt you, young man. What about if you take him to a police station? Tell me what police station you take him to and we'll come down and then we'll meet you down there at some point.
Right. Okay, I can do that.
Yeah, yeah.
I can do that, but the other thing is, obviously,
Alex,
when you come down to the police station, you sign some paperwork and stuff, someone will then, probably a family social worker will have to come up to you, and
can you just give me one moment, please? If you take Bobby to a police station, and I'll meet you there in about 4 hours, that way someone can look
after
him.
Right, I'll tell
you
what. I'll meet you up in Polito, okay? I'll meet you at that police station.
Okay. I sound like Chinese now.
That'll take me half an hour, not 4 hours. How does it take you
half an hour? You said half an hour about half an hour ago.
Right, I'm on my way now. It's because you keep calling me, so I'm having to pull over.
Well, just you said you got your Bluetoothy thingy,
my baby. Yeah, I've got my radio on, but it's a bit annoying.
Panic button activation for officer stab. Stand down, please. Stand down.
Oh.
Hello.
Hello, Mr. Ming.
Oh, not...
Hello.
Yeah, hello.
Is Jean here? I mean, Joan.
Hello, Joan.
Sorry. I was talking to Jean. I'm so sorry. So we're at the police station at Sandy Shores, like you said.
Yeah.
Where are you?
I'm about 15 minutes away, okay?
You're 15 minutes away from Sandy Shores?
From the station, yeah.
So just to confirm, you're going to Sandy Shores
station? No, to Palito station.
No! You said Sandy Shores!
I said Palito!
You said Sandy Shores! Oh, for God! Gee, you stupid woman!
I tell you what, how did you get to Sandy Shores?
How did I get to Sandy Shores?
Did you go on the bus, car? How did you get there?
Jean drove.
Okay. Will it be quicker for me to come to... Actually, no. No. Come to Palito, and I'll meet you there, yeah?
God, blimey, this summer holiday is a nightmare. Jean, can you get your seatbelt on and start putting your foot down where you are?
Text me the address for your care home.
What do you mean text? What's text?
Not text, sorry. Just tell me your address for the care home, and I'll meet you there.
124,
yeah.
Are you writing this down?
Yeah. Oh, hold on. Bear me a second.
We're all in 4-4s, mate. Again. We're all in 4-4s.